that when the Constitution was written, in some way or other, it must have excluded those of us who were slaves at that time. And because we were excluded from the Constitution when it was originally written, today they have to amend it in order to include us. But if you notice, the Civil War didn't include us in the Constitution. Had the Civil War included us in the Constitution, we would be citizens today. Had the amendments even to the Constitution actually included us, we would be citizens today. If the Supreme Court desegregation decision way back in 1954 was sufficient to include us into the jurisdiction of the Constitution, all of our problems would be solved today. So there's something about civil rights that makes it almost impossible for us to get it. So you have to know the difference between civil rights and human rights. As long as our people are begging for civil rights, or they are labeling their struggle for freedom, justice, and equality under the label of civil rights, then what they do is leave us in the jurisdiction of Uncle Sam's courts. And it's actually Uncle Sam who is guilty of all of the violation of our rights that have taken place in this country. So when you go to Uncle Sam to try and get some kind of redress over civil rights violations, you're taking your case to the man who's responsible for the violation. So the only way our people can really get some meaningful results, it has to be taken out of Uncle Sam's hands and taken into a world court.
Africa. So let us begin by 1, exploring the black man in the ancient world, and 2, slavery in the ancient world. In order to do this, we must go back to the birthplace of the black man.
Yeah.
Africa.
Yeah. Massa Pubeson. Asa Pubeson ba. Asa Pubeson when ya kwa wabwa kwa mba.
Aye.
Ah. Massa Pubeson. Sabubeson wonya nyimo obotu apa
ai
wonya yiro obaso apa
ai
wonya kuro obetu apa
ai
akunyo
ai
akunyo ai.
When life became unbearable for the slaves, they found their solace in their God. They slipped away and in Brush Harbor meetings told God all their troubles. Out of these troubled gatherings came the great mournful spirituals.
Thank you.
You ain't no more in Africa, Guinea man. You listen to old fiddler, you wants to keep it live. You in America now. You hear me talking, nigga? You in America.
It's about you.
Are you somebody? I said, damn right I'm somebody. What do you say when I say, are you somebody?
Damn right I'm somebody.
Lynn Collins, Miss Collins, are you somebody?
Yes, I am somebody.
Well, she is. She's a lady. She's
right on.
Mr. Yeah. Ray, are you somebody?
Yeah, right.
Are you somebody, Brother Pagnon?
Damn right.
You sure got a lot of grip to say that. Are you somebody, Brother Parker?
Damn right I'm somebody.
Yeah.
What about you, Assalamu Alaikum? Well, Salaam Alaikum. You know, we speak of love and happiness.